Hello. In this short demonstration, I will show you how you can ease your post-production when you're doing some multicam production thanks to Multicam Logger from Softron Media Services. First, you need to be recording your different camera ISOs. For that, you can use either movie recorder and control it with movie recorder control. You see here the user interface of movie recorder control, which allows me to record multiple camera on a single Mac. But you can be recording also all your camera ISOs using any other recording method that you would prefer. You can record on your camera, you can record on anything else. I'll show you here using movie recorder, but remember, you can record your different camera feeds with anything you would want. Okay, so let's start with recording. All right, you see I'm recording all my camera ISOs. Now we'll go and jump to Multicam Logger. Multicam Logger is an application that will connect to a production switcher, such as the one from Blackmagic, the ATEM line, Television Studio, or any ATEM, but also any other production switcher will work. What you'll have to do in preferences, you'll have to say if you're using an ATEM production switcher, then you can connect through an IP address. If you are using any other production switcher, you will be using GPI to connect with your production switcher and to detect when each camera is selected. Now, you are in Multicam Logger. What you will do is you will say that you will start logging. Before the live shows starts, you will click on that button to start logging what is happening on your production switcher, what camera the director takes. Start recording. You will see now I have camera one selected with the start time code. Now, every time the director will take a different camera, and you'll see here the red is what is in program and the green is what is in preview. Okay, so you'll see that when it changes, when the program changes, the director takes camera one, two, four, and goes on, and you see that every time that a camera has changed, you will see that there is a log that is done. You can also add some markers here, just clicking on that button or hitting a shortcut, keyboard shortcut, and renaming the way you want. Let's say there was a wrong camera. Okay, I will do that a little bit bigger so we can see it better. There is also a different type of marker. That's the to-dos. For that, I use the Alt key and M, which shows me a different color. You see, this is a regular marker. This is a to-do. We'll see a little bit later in the editing solution how it can be used. And for that, I'll say correct this. And you go on like that with your markers. And during that time, of course, the production goes on, and you see all the time that you do that. You see time code in, time code out, and the duration you have stayed on that specific angle. Once the production is over, you stop logging. You go in your recorders, over recorder or whatever else, and you stop the recording. Yes, I'm over with my recording. In Multicam Logger, you don't record any video. You only record what is happening when. So now, with each camera that has been used, you need to link a video file. The video file can be, again, recorded from movie recorder and movie recorder control. And for that, it's very easy. You simply have your camera one there and drag and drop on camera one. I'll put it like that. Second one, camera two. But of course, if you didn't record with movie recorder, what you do is you go there and you go into movies, multicam, and here are your different recordings from camera one, camera two, camera three, drag and drop here, drag and drop there. Or you can even use the little icon there to link to a different movie. You can delete, you can reveal in Finder. Note that you can link multiple files per angle. For example, if you are recording your camera ISO 1 on the camera and the cameraman has stopped and restarted the recording, then you will have multiple files for each angle. You simply drag and drop the multiple files on the one angle. Once you have done that, I'll close that. Once you have done that, you have this other button, Export Multicam. When you click on that button, you set a project name. I'll call it My Multicam. I want to export it for Final Cut Pro 10, Final Cut Pro 7, or Adobe Premiere Pro. I will set the format, 1080i, 19, that frame rate, the render format, if it's drop frame, and how you want to synchronize the different angles. That's very important. And of course, you will mainly want to sync your angles using the start time code. As you have seen here, we have logged at which time code it has started. You should record in all your recordings, in all your files, you should have a timecode track. This timecode track will allow us to synchronize the different recordings and put them at the right moment in the multicam clip. If you don't have a timecode track, let's say you have a DSLR or anything else that doesn't have a timecode track, you can use Content Created. So we will check at what time the file has been created and we will try to match it to a timecode. Or you can say, I had no timecode there, I had not even a creation date, and I will just synchronize with nothing. When it's nothing, then it means that everything starts at the beginning and you can do the synchronization yourself later on. And the audio source, you can set that you want to switch the audio with the video, or that the audio always comes from one specific source. Let's say it always comes from camera one. Then you click on OK. You see you have your file name and you set it to My Multicam. And you have an option here, Send to Video Editing Software. If you disable that option, it will only save an XML file in the format that you have requested for Final Cut Pro 10, Final Cut Pro 7, or Premiere Pro, and do nothing else. Then what you will have to do is later on, you go to your editing station and you import that XML file in your editing solution. But here I want to show you, with the option enabled, what it will do. I click Save, and you see that it immediately opens Final Cut Pro 10, because that's what I have selected, and it will show you your multicam already imported with all the different change of angles. You see here a change of angle and all my markers that I have set. If I show the list, you see the different tags, here it is, and you see the different markers that I have set. Marker one, the wrong camera. And that's where I wanted to show you the different type of markers. You have the regular one, but you have a to-do. And if you click there in this list, you see that I've dropped there. And I can say, oh, I have to correct that. And I can do whatever I want. I can split the clip. I can do a color correction. And once you have done this, you just tick that box here. And here it is. It's corrected. And it's done. So it's very easy. You can change the angle, you can play that, and you will see that it plays fine. Of course, the best is if you show the angles and then you see your different angles. Let's even hide that. Here it is. And you see the different angles and you can change that. You can say, okay, I want to continue from here and I will cut there. And you continue your post-production there. You can do really whatever you want. Also, I told you that you could synchronize later on yourself. If you right click, you open in Angle Editor. This opens the multicam clip and allow you to synchronize differently. You may see that this camera is a little bit later, or and you can move things around like that. There are even plugins, external plugins from Pluralize, for example, that allow you to synchronize with the audio or with any other method. So it's really a flexible method to do a multicam production and to do the post-production later on. Again, I've shown it here with Final Cut Pro 10. It works with Final Cut Pro 7 and Adobe Premiere Pro. So all in all, I think that Multicam Logger is a very neat and easy solution for anybody doing multicam production and that want to deliver the cleanest and most beautiful deliverable on the web for the streaming. Thanks for watching.